بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. All praises due to Allah, and may the peace and blessings and salutations of Allah be upon His final messenger Muhammad and upon His family and His companions.
أخواني, في سنة 1990 عندما كان الغزو العراقي على الكويت.
In the year 1990, when the first Gulf War took place in Kuwait.
وكنا في الكويت في ذاك الوقت وقت الغزو.
The Sheikh said that in Kuwait during that time they were obviously engaged in this war.
وكنا بعد المغرب نتجالس ونتحادث فيما بيننا حتى نخفف عنا أثر هذا الغزو أثناء الغزو.
The Sheikh said that after Salatul Maghrib every day they would sit together and they would talk to each other to take their minds off the war and what was going on.
فكنت ألقي عليهم بعض الكلمات فيما يتعلق بالمناسبات القرآنية.
And the Sheikh, he would spend some time just giving lectures and small pieces of advice concerning the eloquence of the Quran.
فذكرت لهم المناسبة ما بين سورة الكهف وسورة مريم, آخر سورة الكهف وأول سورة مريم.
The Sheikh said, so he spoke on one of those occasions about the relationship between the ending of Surah Al-Kahf with the beginning of Surah Al-Maryam.
إذ قال الله عز وجل في آخر سورة الكهف.
Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says at the end of Surah Al-Kahf.
فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه.
Whosoever hopes in the meeting with their Lord.
فليعمل عملا صالحا.
Then let them do righteous deeds.
ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا.
And let them not associate anyone in the worship of Allah.
فمن أراد أن يفوز بأفضل ما يعطاه العبد وهو النظر إلى الله تبارك وتعالى.
And whosoever wants what is the greatest reward, and that is to be able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
فعليه يحرص على أمرين.
Then he should be eager to attain two things.
الإخلاص.
That is sincerity.
وأن يسير على سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على الطريقة الشرعية.
And a person should be following the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه النظر إلى الله تبارك وتعالى.
So whosoever wants to meet Allah and look on His face.
فليعمل عملا صالحا ليتبع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الطريقة الشرعية.
Then let them do righteous deeds, meaning follow the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in their actions.
وليخلص ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحد.
And let them have sincerity by not worshipping anyone other than Allah.
فابتدأت سورة مريم.
So then Surah Maryam begins thereafter.
بقصة زكريا عليه السلام.
With the story of the Prophet Zakaria عليه السلام.
الذي لم يرزق بمولود عندما كان شابا.
Who at a young age didn't have any children.
وعندما كان زوجته شابة لم يرزق بمولود.
And when his wife was a young woman, they had no children.
الآن كبر سنه.
But now he was an elderly man.
وزوجته كبر سنها.
And his wife, she was an elderly woman.
وهي كذلك عاقر.
And she was barren.
ولكنه أخلص في دعائه لله عز وجل.
But he was sincere, Zakaria عليه السلام was sincere in the dua that he made to Allah.
وعمل عملا صالحا.
And he did righteous deeds.
لأن دعا الله عز وجل في الليل.
Because he made dua to Allah during the night.
رب إني وهن العظم مني.
And he said, Oh my Lord, my bones have become weak.
واشتعل الرأس شيبا.
And my hair has turned grey.
ولم أكن بدعائك رب شقي.
But I never despaired from making dua to you, O my Lord. And I fear for those people who will come after me. And my wife is old, she's past the age of bearing children. So grant for me, bestow upon me from yourself a successor. So then an angel descended upon the Prophet Zakaria alayhi salam. And he said, O Zakaria, we give you glad tidings of a son by the name of Yahya. No one before him has ever had this name. Zakaria alayhi salam was amazed by this. He made the dua, so why is he amazed? So he said, Oh my Lord, how can I possibly have a son? And my wife is too old. And I have also reached old age. So the angel replied, This is the command of your Lord. And it is very easy to do for Allah. The Sheikh said, after he mentioned this to the brothers when they were in their sitting, and the Sheikh left, one of those people, he came to him. And he was of a similar age to the Sheikh. And at that time, they were both around the age of 30.
فأسر إلي.
So he came to me in private and said,
قال إني تزوجت منذ 12 سنة.
He said, I have been married for 12 years.
ولم أرزق بشيء.
And I have no child.
طرقت كل أبواب الطب.
I have tried every single medical avenue.
ولا نتيجة.
But there has been no result.
فبماذا تنصحني؟
So what do you advise me with?
قلت له يوجد باب ربما لم تطرق.
The Sheikh said, I said to him, perhaps there is one door that you never knocked upon.
قال ما تركت بابا إلا وطرقته.
He replied, I've knocked on every single door imaginable.
قلت له طرقت باب الله عز وجل.
So the Sheikh said to him, did you knock on the door of Allah?
سكت.
He went quiet.
قلت له ما سمعت قصة زكريا عليه السلام.
So I said to him, did you not just hear of the story of زكريا عليه السلام?
أصبح عجوز.
He was an old man.
ومرأته عاقل.
And his wife was an old woman.
وأصبحت مرأة عجوز.
And she was too past the age of childbearing.
ومع ذلك عندما أخلص ودعا الله عز وجل أكرمه الله عز وجل بالمولود.
But when he was sincere and he made sincere dua to Allah, Allah bestowed him with a son.
اطرق باب الله.
So knock on the door of Allah.
واسلك سبيل الطب وابحث.
And at the same time carry on researching medicine and so on.
ولكن جاء أمامك باب الله عز وجل.
But place before you the door of Allah.
قال نعم الرأي.
He said okay.
مرت الأيام.
Many days passed by.
تقريبا بعد ما يقارب سنة.
After a year had passed.
صليت العصر في المسجد.
He said I prayed عصر one day.
في نفس المسجد الذي يصلي فيه.
And we used to pray in the same masjid.
وكنت في أقصى اليمين في الصف الأول.
He's saying I was praying. The Sheikh said I was praying in the front row, but towards the right.
وإذا هو قد صلى في أقصى الشمال في الصف الأول.
And he was praying on the left side of the front row.
بعد صلاة العصر.
After Asr prayer.
أتاني وجلس بقربي.
He came all the way to me and sat next to me.
قال عدنان أبشرك.
He said, Oh Adnan, I have good news.
قلت ما هو؟
I said, What's your news?
قال رزقت بأربعة.
He said, I have four children now.
ببنتي بذكرين وأنثيين.
I have two sons and two daughters.
في حملة واحدة.
They were quintuplets.
عسى الله عز وجل يبارك له في ذريته.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and his children.
ويبارك لنا في ذرياتنا.
And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our children as well.
ولذلك إخواني الدعاء لا بد له من شروط.
So that's why when you make dua, there are certain conditions that you first must fulfill.
حتى يقبل هذا الدعاء.
So that this dua will be accepted by Allah.
الشرط الأول.
The first condition.
أن يكون خالصا لله تبارك وتعالى.
That it is sincerely for the sake of Allah.
كما سمعنا في هذه الآية.
Just as we mentioned in the story that we mentioned in the Quran.
فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه.
Whosoever hopes for the meeting with their Lord,
فليعمل عملا صالحا.
Then let them do righteous deeds.
ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا.
And let them not associate anyone in the worship of Allah.
فعليه أن يخلص في دعائه لله تبارك.
So a person must be sincere in their dua to Allah.
لا يتوجه إلى قبر.
They don't go towards a grave.
ولا يجعل قلبه يتعلق بمخلوق.
Nor is their heart attached to any other creation.
جوارحه ربما تتعلق بالمخلوقات.
Perhaps your limbs, your body will be attached to other people and other means.
أما القلب لا يتعلق إلا بالله.
Whereas for your heart, it is only attached to Allah.
والأمر الثاني.
The second condition of the second thing.
أن يكون الدعاء مشروعا.
That the dua that you make it is something which is halal, allowed for you to make.
كيف يكون مشروعا؟
How is it something which is allowed for you?
ألا يدعو بإثم.
That you don't ask Allah to, or you don't make dua for a sin.
أو قطيعة رحم.
Or for example, to break off with your family members.
لا يدعو الله عز لا يدعو الله عز وجل بأن ييسر له أمر الربا أو أمر القمار أو أمر الخمر.
And you don't ask Allah to make it easy for you to take interest or to gamble or to drink.
أو قتل فلان أو سب فلان أو شتم فلان فلان لا يستحق.
Or for example that you want to kill someone or harm someone or curse someone.
ولذا قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And that's why the Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يستجاب لأحدكم.
It is your dua is accepted.
ما لم يدعو بإثم.
So long as you don't ask for something which is haram.
أو قطيعة رحم.
Or you don't ask to break off with your family members.
إذن هذا الشرط الثاني.
So this is the second condition.
الشرط الثالث.
The third condition.
ألا يستعجل في الدعاء.
That you shouldn't be hasty in asking for a response for your dua.
يقول دعوت فلم يستجب لي.
You don't say I made dua once, twice, and no response has come.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يستجاب لأحدكم.
Your dua will be answered.
ما لم يعجل.
So long as you are not hasty.
يقول دعوت دعوت فلم يستجب لي.
And you don't say I made dua, but no response came.
فيدع الدعاء.
No.
فيترك بعد ذلك.
And then after that, you just don't make any more dua.
فعليه ألا يستعجل.
So don't be hasty.
فالله عز وجل هو يعلم متى الوقت المناسب للإجابة على هذا.
Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the appropriate time in which to answer this dua.
ولأنك في كل دعوة تدعوها.
And every time you make dua to Allah.
إما أن الله عز وجل يحقق لك دعوتك.
Either Allah will respond and accept your dua.
أو يبدلك بأفضل من هذه الدعوة.
Or he will give you something better in return.
لأن هذه لأن الإجابة لهذه الدعوة لا تصلح لك.
Because to respond to the dua that you're asking for, it's not in your best interest.
فيكرمك بأفضل منها أو مثلها.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you something else similar to it or better than it.
أو يؤخرها إلى يوم القيامة.
Or he delays responding to you until the day of judgment.
فإذن هذا الأمر الثالث ألا يستعجل في الدعاء.
So the third condition or etiquette is that you're not hasty in your dua.
الأمر الرابع.
The fourth issue.
إنه إذا دعا الله تبارك وتعالى عليه أن يحضر قلبه.
When you make dua to Allah, you should make it with an attentive heart.
أي تتدبر وأنت تدعو بهذا الدعاء.
Meaning that you contemplate over the dua that you're making.
عقلك وقلبك مع هذا الدعاء.
Your mind and your heart are present when you make dua.
تعيش مع هذا الدعاء.
You're living in with that dua.
أخواني أحد الشباب يخبرني.
The Sheikh said that someone once told him.
وهو من أهل الكويت.
الكويت.
وهو من الكويت.
He's from Kuwait.
أتى إلى بريطانيا هنا للدراسة.
He said that this brother he came to the UK to study.
يقول استأجرت بيتا لأسكن أنا وأهلي فيه.
So he said I rented a property for myself and my family.
ومالك البيت هو من إحدى الدول العربية.
And the owner of that property or that house also came from an Arab country.
يقول عندما استأجرت منه البيت وقعني على 13 ورقة كلها قوانين.
He said when I signed the rental agreement with this man, the agreement was 13 pages long.
وكنت لا أعرف أنا كنت أثق وثقت فيه كما أخبرني عنه أحد الشباب. وثقت فيه ووقعت هذه الورقة.
He said, I didn't read this contract. I just trusted this man and I signed the contract.
وأنا لا أعرف الإنجليزية أتيت لتعلم اللغة.
And he didn't know English. He came to learn English, so he couldn't read, understand what was in the contract.
يقول وكنت أتعامل معه بأعلى درجات المعاملة وأحسن درجات المعاملة.
He said, I would treat the owner of the property, my landlord, I would treat him in a very nice way.
وكنت في بداية كل شهر ربما قبل كل شهر أعطيه إيجار البيت.
And before the time came for my rent to be due, I would already have paid him.
وأذهب إليه في بيته وأعطيه.
And I would go to his house and I would give him the rent, go to him myself.
تصل الرسائل إليه من خلال بيتنا من خلال بيت المستأجر أخذها وأرسلها إليه.
And if he had post coming to this house which belonged to him, he would take the post and take it to his new house.
حتى قال لي والله ما وجدت أحدا استأجر بيتي مثلك أنت.
Until my landlord said to me, I've never had a tenant better than you.
لا أريدك أن تخرج.
And I don't want you to leave this house.
فقلت له لا بأس لكن غير لي بعض الأمور.
So I said to him, okay, but I just need you to make some improvements.
قال لا ما في شيء تغير لا أغير شيئا.
He said, no, I can't change anything.
وكنت أرى نواقص كثيرة في البيت.
But this brother was saying the tenant that I saw that there were many problems with the house.
يقول كلما ذهبت إليه شغل المسجل يسجلني.
So every time I would go to him, he would start to record me.
حتى في كل كلمة أقولها يسجلني.
Everything I'd say to him would be recorded.
يقول في بداية الأمر عندما استأجرت بيته.
He said at the beginning when I first rented the house.
قال لي لو وجدت بيتا آخر ما يضر وقعت معي وإذا وجدت بيتا آخر في أي وقت تستطيع أن تترك بيتي وتذهب.
When I first rented the house, he said to me, "It's okay if you find a better house, you can leave, even though you've made a contract. It's okay, you can leave. I'll let you go and go to that other house."
يقول عندما وجدت بيتا آخر.
So he said, "But when I found another house."
قلت له أريد الخروج.
I said to him that I want to leave and move there.
قال لا أنت وقعت معي.
He said, no, you signed a contract with me.
أقل شيء تمكث عندي ستة أشهر كما هو في العقد.
So you have to spend at least 6 months according to the contract in this house.
قال فجلست في بيتي وأنا متضايق.
So he said, the tenant, that I became extremely upset.
مرت ستة أشهر.
6 months passed by.
وأنا أتعامل معه بأفضل أنواع المعاملة.
But I was still treating him in a very respectful way.
ويسجلني في كل كلمة عندما آتي إليه.
And he would record everything that I would say to him.
عندما انتهت ستة أشهر قلت له أريد الخروج وأريد أن أبحث عن مكان آخر.
After 6 months, I said to him, now I'm going to leave and find another property.
فقال لا ما تستطيع.
He said, no, you're not allowed.
قلت كيف؟
I said to him, why?
قال لابد أن تخبرني قبل شهرين. انتهت ستة أشهر لابد أن تمكث شهرين.
He said,
أن تخبرني قبل شهرين.
He said, you have to give me 2 months notice before you leave.
قال فعشت في ضائقة.
So he said, I became even more upset.
فقلت له أنا أتعامل معك بأحسن معاملة.
And he said to him that I treat you in a very nice, respectful way.
ونحن إخوة وكل مسلمون.
We are Muslims and we are brothers.
قال دع الأخوة ودع المعاملة جهة المال جهة أخرى.
He said, forget about brotherhood and forget about your everything else, your etiquettes. That's one thing. Money is something else.
قال فخرجت من بيتي وأنا ضاق الصدر.
He said, so I left and I was very upset.
وصليت الجمعة في صلاة الجمعة.
And I prayed the Jum'ah prayer.
قال وفي السجود دعوت الله عز وجل.
And in prostration in sujood, I made dua to Allah.
قلت ربي إني مغلوب فانتصر.
And I said, oh Allah, I have been oppressed, so help me.
وهي دعوة نوح عليه السلام.
And this is the same dua that Nuh عليه السلام made.
ربي إني مغلوب فانتصر.
Oh Allah, I have been oppressed and overcome, so help me.
ودعوت الله عز وجل بصدق.
So I made sincere dua to Allah.
ذهبت البيت.
I then went home.
فإذا جاري بريطاني الأصل.
He said, I had a white neighbor.
أتى إلي.
He came to me.
وقال أريد أن أستسمحك في شيء.
And he said, I seek your permission to ask you about something.
قلت ما هو؟
He said, what?
قال كأني ربما أخبرك بشيء قد يعكر عليك مزاجك ويؤذيك.
He said, maybe I'll tell you something, but you're going to get even more upset.
قلت لا تفضل.
I said, no, go ahead.
قال تعرف مالك البيت؟
He said, do you know the owner of this property?
قلت نعم.
I said, yes.
قال بالأمس أتى ودخل بيتك.
He said last night he came and he entered into your house.
قال فثار دمي. ثار في الدم.
So he said I became upset when I heard that he just entered into my house without permission.
قال بل أقول لك يكررها هذه ليست أول مرة بكثرة يدخل بيتك عندما تخرج أنت وأهلك من البيت.
But the neighbor said it's not the first time he does this often when you and your family aren't home he comes and he just enters into your house.
قال كيف أن الله عز وجل أنزل علي هذه المسألة لا أعلم.
He said I don't know how this happened to me.
ذهبت إليه وأنا في قمة الغضب.
He said I went to my landlord and I was extremely angry.
وكان هو يريد كاف أن يأخذ مني التأمين الذي هو راتب أو إيجار شهر كامل كذلك آخر.
And my next month's rent was now due.
والذي يسمى عندكم ديبوزيت ما ديبوزيت.
And he was asking for another deposit as well.
ومقداره 700 باوند تقريبا.
And it was 700 pounds that he had to pay.
قال فذهبت إليه.
Said, so I went to him.
وطرقت عليه الباب.
And I knocked on his door.
فقال تفضل ادخل ادخل.
And he said to me, come in.
قلت لن أدخل أخرج أنت.
I said to him, no, I'm not going to come in. You come out.
خرج إليه.
So he came out.
قلت دخلت عليه البيت.
So I said to him, did you come into my house?
دون إذني.
Without my permission.
فتلعثم.
So he became very nervous.
حاول أن ينكر.
And he tried to say, rejected, say no.
قلت عندي شاهد على هذا.
So I said to him that I have a witness.
قال فانهار الرجل.
So he went completely quiet.
فخرج إلي.
And then he came out to
وخرج
me.
وخرج زوجته إلي.
And then his wife came out.
وأخذ يعتذر.
And they began to apologize.
كل ما تريده حققه لك.
And they said, we'll give you whatever you want.
قلت القضاء القضاء عند القاضي الكلام.
So I said to him, I'm going to take you to court.
قال فذهبت.
So I left.
أتى إلي كما يقال بلباسه لباس النوم أتى إلي البيت وهو زوجته.
So they followed me home and they were in their pajamas.
وأخذ يضرب علي الباب.
And they began to knock on my door.
قال انهار تماما.
So the guy was like completely lost.
قال أقبل رأسك.
He said I will kiss your forehead.
وذلك أن فيها كما يقال هذه جريمة عندكم أظنها.
Because he had just committed a crime.
قال كل ما تريد أحققه لك.
So he said I will do whatever you want.
قلت الله أكبر.
So the man, the tenant, the brother, he said, Allahu Akbar.
كل ما أريده الآن سيتحقق لي.
So everything that he wanted will now come into action, will become a reality.
اشترطت عليه عدة شروط.
So I made many conditions with him.
قال أقبلها بدون أن أقرأها بدون أي شيء أنا قابلها.
And the landlord said, I'll accept all of your conditions. I don't even need to read them.
قلت قلت سبحان الله.
So I said سبحان الله.
دعوة واحدة.
One dua that I made.
بصدق.
But it was sincere.
الله عز وجل أسقط هذا الرجل الذي أخذه كان الذي كان يترفع عليه وظلمني.
And Allah سبحانه وتعالى humiliated this man who used to oppress me.
وهو مدير جامعة.
And he was the chancellor of a university.
أخواني دعوة من قلب صادق الله عز وجل يحققها لك.
So see how a sincere dua Allah سبحانه وتعالى will respond to it.
وربما تسقط أعلى الناس.
And perhaps the most noble of people will be humiliated as a result.
ولذا هذا الشرط الرابع.
So this is the fourth condition.
كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
As the Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فإن الله لا يستجيب دعاء من قلب غافل لاهن.
That Allah, the Prophet ﷺ said that Allah does not respond to a dua from a heart which is heedless and neglectful.
هذا الشرط الرابع.
This is the fourth condition.
إذا دعوت الله عز وجل.
When you make dua to Allah.
فليكن قلبك حاضرا.
You must have an attentive heart.
تدبر.
You must contemplate.
الشرط الخامس.
The fifth etiquette.
إطابة المأكل والمشرب.
And that is that you must be careful in that which you consume, your food and drink.
أن يكون مصدر الطعام مباح.
And that is that the money that you have in order to buy your food, it is halal.
ويكون مصدر الشراب مباح.
And likewise, the money that you use for your drink, it is halal.
ومصدر اللباس مباح.
And likewise, for your clothes, the money that you have that you buy your clothes with is halal.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث مسلم.
The Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم in what is collected in Sahih Muslim.
عن رجل فقير.
About a poor man.
قلبه حاضر.
And he had an attentive heart.
ومحتاج إلى الله عز وجل.
And he was in a state of poverty and need.
وفي شدة افتقار إلى الله تبارك وتعالى.
And he was impoverished to Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
وليس له إلا الله تبارك وتعالى.
And he has no one else to turn to except Allah.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet said about him صلى الله عليه وسلم.
رب أشعث أغبر.
Perhaps a man who is dusty and disheveled.
يمد يديه إلى السماء.
He will raise his hands out and outstretch them towards the heavens.
يقول يا رب يا رب.
And he will say, Oh my Lord. Oh my Lord.
والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول مطعمه حرام.
But the Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم his food is haram.
ومشربه حرام.
And his drink is haram.
وغذي بالحرام.
And he has been nourished upon haram.
وملبسه حرام.
And his food is his clothing is haram.
فأنا يستجاب لذلك.
So how can his dua possibly be answered?
لا يكون طعامك أصله ربوي.
Don't make the food that you eat, don't make it come from wealth which is from riba.
أو أخذته بطريقة محرمة.
Oh, you took that money from an unlawful means.
وكذلك ملبسك.
And the same for your clothes.
وكذلك مسكنك ومشربك.
And the same for where you live and what you drink.
وإلا فإنك تدعو ولا يستجاب لك.
Because otherwise, irrespective of how many du'as you make, Allah will not respond.
إذن هذا الشرط الخامس.
This is the fifth condition.
إطابة المطعم والمشرب والمأكل والملبس.
And that is that where you live and where you what you eat and what you drink and what you wear, all of it comes from halal.
هذه الشروط الخمسة.
These five conditions.
قالوا بعضهم زاد شرطا سادسا.
Some of them they added a sixth extra condition.
وهو الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And that is that you send salutations upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وذلك أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
Because the Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم.
عندما رأى رجلا قد صلى.
When he saw a man who had made salah,
ودع الله عز وجل,
and he made dua,
ولم يصلي على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم,
but he didn't make salat upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم,
so the Prophet said to him صلى الله عليه وسلم,
لقد تعجل هذا.
This person is too hasty.
وذلك لما؟
Why?
لأنه لم يصلي على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Because he didn't send salat and salam upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعد ذلك علمه أن يصلي على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أراد الدعاء.
So after this, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us that when we make dua, we must send salutations upon him.
أخوان الآن نأتي إلى ما يسمى بالأوقات المستجابة.
So now we come on to the issue of what are the best times to make dua.
تخير الأوقات المستجابة حتى يستجاب لك.
Use those times that are recommended so that your dua will be answered.
أتاني أحد الشباب.
The sheikh said that someone came to him.
في الليل.
During the night.
وشرح لي مشكلته.
And he had a problem that he explained to him.
قال حصلت لي مشكلة مع عمي.
He said that I have a problem with my uncle.
وهددني بالقتل.
And he threatened to kill me as a result.
قال فذهبت إلى المخفى مخفر الشرطة.
So I went to the police station.
فقلت لهم ذلك.
And I told them about this threat.
فاستدعى عمي.
So they called my uncle.
فأتى عمي مع أبي مع عمي الآخر.
So my uncle came along with my father and another uncle as well.
فأصلحوا بيننا.
And they made us reconcile between ourselves.
لكن إصلاح ظاهري.
But this is just something that was just done for the sake of it.
خرجنا من المخفى.
When we came out of the police station.
فقال لي أبي وعمي إياك أن تدخل بيتنا بعد اليوم.
My uncle and my father, both of them, said to me, "Don't ever come into our house again."
قال كأنهم قطعوني من شجرة.
So they had cut me off completely.
فكل أعمامي هجروني.
And then all of my other uncles stopped talking to me.
وكذلك عماتي كلهم نهجروا.
And all of my aunts as well.
فقلت ماذا أفعل؟
So I thought to myself, what can I do?
وأخذ يشرح لي مشكلته ما يقارب نصف ساعة وهو يشرح لي.
The Sheikh said it took half an hour for him to explain all of his problems and what he was going through.
قلت له أنا أعرفك.
The Sheikh said, I said to him that I know you.
وأعرف أعمامك جيدا.
And I know your uncles as well.
وما أظن طلب مني أن أجد له حلا.
And he wanted the Sheikh to solve this issue of his.
قلت لا أظن أنني لو جعلت لك حل الآن وضعت حلولا أن تبدأ في الحل من الآن ما يصلح.
So the Sheikh said, despite all of the solutions that I may give you, now is not the right time to start.
لأن الآن لأن أباك وعمك وأعمامك في قمة الغضب الآن.
Because your father and your uncles, all of them are extremely angry with you at the moment.
انتظر حتى تهدأ الأمور.
So wait until things calm down.
وأظن نحتاج مدة شهرين حتى نبدأ بالحل.
So we have to wait for at least 2 months before we start to solve this issue.
قال لي ماذا أفعل؟
So he said, what shall I do?
قلت لكنني أدلك على طريق واحد.
So the Sheikh said, I said to him that I will give you one thing that you can do now.
وأظنه فيه حل سريع.
And maybe this will solve all of your problems quickly.
ويحل المشكلة بسرعة.
And all of your issues will be resolved.
قال ما هو؟
He asked me what it was.
قلت له كم بذلت من الوقت وأنت تجلس معي وتشرح لي هذه المشكلة؟
I said to him, how much time have you just spent with me now, telling me about your issues and your problems?
قال تقريبا نصف ساعة.
So he said probably half an hour.
قلت له آخر الليل.
So I said to him during the last third of the night.
قم آخر الليل قبل الفجر.
Stand before the Fajr prayer.
وتوضأ.
And make wudu.
وصلي ركعتين.
And pray 2 rak'ahs.
وأنت في السجود.
And when you go into sajda.
اشتك لله عز وجل باللهجة وبالطريقة التي اشتكيتها إلي. اشتك إلى الله عز وجل بكل ما في قلبك.
Complain to Allah and mention all of your problems to Him just as you mentioned them to me now.
بلهجتك.
In your own language.
وانظر بعد ذلك كيف تفرج لك الأمور.
And see how then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will solve your issues.
قال خير إن شاء الله.
He said okay.
ذهب.
He went.
بعد أسبوع رأيته.
I saw him then after a week.
قلت له ماذا فعلت؟
And I said to him, what did you do?
ابتسم ابتسامة كبيرة.
He had a very wide smile on his face.
قلت ماذا حصل؟
I said to him, what's wrong?
قال استيقظت قبل الفجر ودعوت الله عز وجل.
He said, I woke up before Fajr and I made dua to Allah.
من الغد.
The next day.
ذهبت إلى السوق.
I was going to shopping. I was going shopping.
ودائما أذهب أنا إلى السوق هذا.
And I would always pass through the shopping center.
قال عند دخولي السوق.
As I was entering there.
رأيت عمي قد خرج من السوق.
I saw that my uncle was walking in the opposite direction. He was coming out.
هذا الذي اشتكيت عليه.
This is the same uncle that he had the problem with.
قال فذا ولم ألتقي يوما ما منذ سنين وأنا لم ألتقي يوما ما بعمي عند دخولي السوق ومع خروجي هو.
And he said, all the times that I would enter into the shopping center, I never saw my uncle in that shopping center.
قال فالتقيت بدخولي فإذا هو خارج.
But on this day, as I was going in, he was coming out.
فنظر إلي.
So he looked at me.
فتوجه إلي.
And then he came to me.
فأخذني وضمني إلي.
And then he took me and he hugged me.
وقال له اعذرني على خطأي.
And he said, forgive me for my mistake.
أنا أخطأت في حقك.
I was wrong.
قال وقفت واستطعت أن أجيبه.
So the brother, he said, I didn't know how to respond.
ما توقعت أن يحصل هذا الأمر.
I never expected this to happen so quickly.
هذه المشكلة تحتاج إلى سنين حتى تحل.
Sometimes these things take years for them to be resolved.
أدخلت عمي وأبي إلى المخفر كيف أحل هذه المشكلة.
Because this issue had gone to the police and so on, how can it be resolved so quickly?
توجهت إلى الله.
But it was because he had turned to Allah.
مدبر الكون.
And he is the one who controls the universe.
مقلب قلوب الخلق.
And he is the one who controls the hearts of the people.
يسر لي كل أموري.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made everything easy for me.
خلال ساعات فقط.
And that is within a few hours.
والذي أحتاج إلى سنوات في ساعة انتهى كل شيء.
And what would normally take years to resolve was resolved in a few hours.
تخيل أوقات المستجابة.
So choose these times when du'as are answered.
روى الترمذي أن رجلا أتى إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And Imam al-Tirmidhi collected that a man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
يا رسول الله.
And he said, O Messenger of Allah.
أي الدعاء أجوب أي استجاب الإنسان إذا ما دعا فيه أي وقت.
Which du'a is most likely to be answered?
قال جوف الليل الآخر.
He said in response. The one that is made during the last part of the night.
في الثلث الأخير من الليل.
It is the last third of the night.
الأمر الثاني.
The second issue.
الوقت كذاك الاستجابة عند في السجود.
The second time when your dua is most likely to be answered is when you're in sajda.
كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
As the Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم.
أقرب ما يكون عبد من ربه وهو ساجد.
The closest place that the slave has towards their Lord is in sajda.
فأكثروا فيه الدعاء.
So make much dua within this
place. فإنه قمن يستجاب لكم أي كثيرا ما يستجاب لكم.
Because it is most likely that your dua will be answered therein.
الوقت الثالث.
The third time.
بين الأذان والإقامة.
Between the Adhan and the Iqama.
وذاك أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Because the Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم.
بين بأنه ما بين النداء ما بين النداءين يستجاب لدعاء أحدكم ما بين النداءين.
He mentioned that the time between the Adhan and the Iqama is a time for du'as to be answered.
إذن هذا الوقت الثالث.
This is the third time.
الوقت الرابع.
The fourth time.
وأنت صائم.
Whilst you're fasting.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول ثلاث لا ترد دعوتهم.
The Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم three people their du'as are not rejected.
الصائم حتى يفطر.
The one who is fasting until he breaks his fast.
أي منذ الفجر إلى غروب الشمس ودعاؤه يستجاب.
Meaning whilst he's fasting from the time of Fajr until Maghrib, that is the time for his du'as to be answered.
ولا يقتصر فقط قبل الإفطار.
And you don't just make du'a before your iftar.
وإنما قال حتى يفطر.
Because the Prophet ﷺ said, all of the time of fasting is a time for du'as to be answered.
أما الحديث حين يفطر هذا لا يصح.
As for the hadith that the du'a is answered just before you make the iftar, that is a weak narration.
ودعوة المظلوم.
And he said also, from those people whose du'as are not rejected is the oppressed.
فإنها تصعد إلى الله كأنها شرارة.
Because it will run up or reach up to Allah like the rocket.
ليس بينها وبين الله حجاب.
And there is no veil between it and Allah. So beware of the dua of the oppressed. And beware of oppressing anyone. Because he may make a dua against you which will destroy you. And the third person is a just ruler. The fifth recommended time when it is raining.
وعندكم بكثرة ينزل المطر.
And this is something which we see often.
الوقت الخامس. الوقت السادس.
The sixth time.
إخواني كان في أحد الشباب تزوج منذ 20 سنة.
He said that he knows someone who was married for 20 years.
ولم يرزق بشيء.
And he had no children.
وكان يأتي يقول لم أرزق بشيء.
And he would come to the sheikh and tell him that he has no children.
قلت له ادعو الله عز وجل.
So I said to him, make dua to Allah. He said, I already make dua. So I said to him, also go to the doctors, go to medicine, see what they can do. So then the time of Hajj came. But the brother, at the same time, he had an appointment in Belgium to go and see some doctors about this issue. So the Sheikh said, the rest of us, we went for Hajj.
وحضرنا عرفة.
And we went to Arafah.
فعندما ركبنا الحافلة قبل الانطلاق من عرفة.
And before we went on the bus to leave from Arafah.
وكنا تقريبا ما يزيد عن 40 شابا.
And we were 40 people all together in our group.
فقبل أن ننطلق في الحافلة.
Before we left on the coach.
ونحن في عرفة.
Whilst we're still in Arafah.
فقلت يا إخوة.
I said to the brothers, oh brothers.
أخوكم لم يرزق بشيء منذ 20 سنة.
This brother of ours, this friend of ours, doesn't have a child, he's been waiting for 20 years.
وهو فلان بن فلان.
And you know him, he's so-and-so.
وبالنسبة له يقول لو رزقت بمولود أشعر بأنها معجزة.
And he's saying that now if he has a child, he'll think this is a miracle.
إخواني كلكم عنده أبناء وبنات وأولاد.
The Sheikh said, I said to the other people there that all of you have children.
وكلكم يستمتع بهذا.
And all of you understand the joys of being a parent.
يا إخوة ادعوا الله عز وجل لأخيكم أن يرزق بمولود.
So why don't we make dua for our brother that Allah gives him a child.
وهو الآن يتعالج في بلجيكا.
And he is at the moment in Belgium because of this issue.
هو مع أهله.
And he's there with his family.
فرفع الإخوة أيديهم.
So everyone raised their hands in dua.
وكل منهم أخذ يدعو له لوحده.
And everyone individually just made their own dua for this brother. We then came back to Kuwait. And the brother came to him, the one who was in Belgium. He said, good news, my wife is pregnant. And he said, this was a dream for me. Even till now, I can't believe this and I won't believe it until I see the child born. Because 20 years I've been waiting. And I felt that my wife would become so old she wouldn't be able to have children anyway. And then he had his child. A year passed by. And 2 years passed by. And he wanted another child.
وحاول كذلك.
And again he tried.
وفي وقت الحج كذلك سافر مع أهله.
And again at the time of Hajj he had traveled for this reason.
ونحن في عرفة قبل الغروب وعند الغروب لإخواني.
So again the Sheikh he said he was with the other brothers in Arafah just before the time of Maghrib in Arafah.
ونحن في الحافلة.
And again when they were on the coach.
قلت يا إخوة ادعوا لأخيكم.
So I said to the brothers, make dua for that brother.
فرفع أيديهم ودعوا الله عز وجل.
And so everyone made dua for him again.
فرجع الكويت فقال بشرك الحمد لله زوجتي حامل.
And then when he went back to Kuwait, he gave him the good news that his wife was pregnant again.
تخيل الأوقات المستجابة.
So look and choose these times when dua is answered.
ومن ذلك دعاء عرفة.
And from amongst those times is the dua on the day of Arafah.
لا تستهن بهذه الأوقات.
Don't think that these times are not important.
تخيل يوم الجمعة.
On the day of Jumu'ah.
فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول.
Because the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
إن فيها ساعة.
Indeed, there is a time on this day.
لا يصادفها عبد مسلم.
That a person doesn't make dua in this time.
يدعو الله تبارك وتعالى.
And they call upon Allah during this time.
إلا استجاب له.
Except that Allah will respond to them.
اختلف العلماء في هذه الساعة.
Scholars they differed over when this time exactly is on a Friday.
ورد عن عبد الله بن سلام أنه قال في العصر.
And Abdullah ibn Salam said it is after Asr.
وهي آخر ساعة من العصر.
And that is the final time between Asr and Maghrib.
ولكنها من قول عبد الله بن سلام ما تصح من قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And this is the opinion of Abdullah ibn Salam. It's not a hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وبعضهم رجح أنها عند دعوة الإمام في خطبة الجمعة.
And others said that it is the time when the Imam makes the dua in the khutbah.
ومن الأوقات المستجابة.
Also from the recommended times.
الدعاء في الصلاة بعد التشهد وقبل السلام.
It is to make dua in the tashahud in the prayer before you make the salams.
كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأحد الصحابة.
As the Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم to one of his companions.
قال وليتخير أي بعد التشهد وعلى الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وليتخير من الدعاء ما شاء.
That after you in your tashahud, after you've sent salat upon the Prophet sallam, choose whichever du'a you want to make.
ولذا الأفضل في دعاء الاستخارة أن تدعو الله عز وجل في الصلاة وبعد التشهد وقبل أن تسلم.
And that's why even when you make the du'a of istikhara, the best time is to do it in tashahud before you make the salam.
الحمد لله رب العالمين.
And all praise is due to Allah.